नो मैटर हाउ फ्यू पोजिशंस यू ओन और हाउ लिटिल मनी यू हैव, लविंग वाइल्ड लाइफ एंड नेचर विल मेक यू रिच बियॉन्ड मेजर्स. गुड आफ्टरनून डियर चिल्ड्रेन. विद दिस नाइस थॉट रादर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आर न्यू चैप्टर एंड नेक्स्ट चैप्टर एनिमल लाइफ. एज वी ऑल नो दैट देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ थिंग्स इन दिस वर्ल्ड, लिविंग एंड नॉन लिविंग. एंड लिविंग थिंग्स आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स, प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स. About plants, we had discussed in our last chapter, and now we will discuss about the other types of living beings. That is, we will discuss about animal world or animal life. Children, have you seen a bird flying and an aeroplane flying? So the answer will be, of course, yes. You must have seen both the things. Both can fly, both produces sound. So what is the difference between a bird and an aeroplane? Most of you will say, ma'am, a bird is a living thing and an aeroplane is a non-living thing. It means you all know that bird is a living thing and aeroplane is a non-living thing. So there must be some characteristics behind that. On the basis of that, you can say. So let's do those characteristics which all the animals show, because they all are living beings. So all animals, as they are living things, they can move. They can move from one place to another. As we can run, we can walk, and a cheetah can run very fast. A frog can hop. Similarly, a bird can fly. So we can see that animals can move from one place to another. All animals, they grow. They grow in size. When they are young, very young, their small, their size is small, and as they grow, as with the age, their size increases. And after a certain time or after a certain age, their size may stop increasing. But with age, they grow. And all animals, they breathe. Means they take in oxygen and they give out carbon dioxide. Like we have nostrils to breathe. Through nostrils we take in oxygen gas and we give out carbon dioxide gas. So without breathing, we cannot live. Try to close your nose and mouth too. So you will feel that you cannot feel yourself easy. You may feel uneasy, and you will try to open your nose, because for living, we need to exchange gases. Like we need oxygen gas and we need to give out carbon dioxide gas. Similarly, all animals reproduce. They give birth to their young ones. Some animals give birth to their babies, and some animals gives eggs through which their babies come out. So, these are some of the characteristics which are shown by all the animals and all living things start their life as a baby and grow with time. They live for a number of years, and all living things, they also die after a certain lifespan. The living world is full of creatures, wonderful creatures rather. And the living world includes plants, animals, insects, worms, birds, and human beings. These all are living things. And animal forms a very important part of living world. Children, till now we had discussed about plant life. Now let's discuss about animal life. Whether at home, on the farm, or at the dinner table, animals play an important role in everyday human life. They serve as companions, means they live with us. We are surrounded by them. They are present in our surroundings. They are a source of livelihood, like cows, buffaloes. They are source of entertainment, like monkeys, etc. They are inspirational for us. And of course, food and clothing to people all across the world. Yet, animals can and do exist independent from people and as living beings. Each and every animal is different by nature and by habits also. Their requirements are different. Their interests are different. And children, we should respect them and should follow the moral of live and let live. Means we should not tease animals. We should not disturb them. We should not take their habitat. We should also allow them to live their life. Children, today, due to human interference, many of the animals are facing danger, and many of them are extinct also. Means they are no longer in this world. They don't exist in this world now. Do you know, without animals, our existence would be in danger, because each and every living being is unique and plays an important role in our life. And you must be knowing many types of animals. You must have gone to zoo and you must have watched many animals there of different kinds, which are maybe very unique looking and maybe very different looking. And some of the animals, they are very common to you, like ants and spiders and cockroaches and like cows, buffaloes, dogs, cats. These all are part of your world. You can see these animals, that they live in our surroundings. Rat, isn't it? And some of the animals, they are not present in our country, and we can see them only in zoo. So this world is full of different types of animals. all the animals of this world make animal kingdom. They are part of animal kingdom. Look at the variety of the animals in this picture. How wonderful they look. They add beauty to our nature. Not only beauty, they are valuable for us. Each creature is valuable for us. They live in different habitat, means they live in different surroundings, different climate. Some live in water, some in trees, some on land, some fly in air, and so on. So this world is full of different type of animals.